Welcome here to TalkFCB and welcome back here to the channel, guys. A Barcelona news roundup coming up for you today, and it's a big one because we have got some colossal quotes from some Barcelona icons against the current board. It is all coming up, the words of Xavi, the words of Messi, and also some doubts over the remainder of the European football season. It's all coming up for you guys. Let's get to it. And if we do quickly cover the latest on European football and the latest on a return date for football, which right now certainly is still in doubt, because UEFA president Alexander Seferin has offered some insight over the weekend there, and he himself, the president of UEFA, has cast doubt over the remainder of the European season. Seferin told La Repubblica over the weekend, an outlet there in Italy, that nobody knows exactly when the pandemic will end. We're in touch with the leagues, the clubs, there is a group that we're working to find a solution. We want to find the best solution for everybody, but we will have to wait just like any other sector. He said it's difficult to imagine all of the games behind closed doors, but right now we don't even know when football return, with or without fans. If there are no alternatives, it would still be better to conclude the leagues, but I can say that right now, I'm not thinking about staging the European Cup Finals, the Champions League, the Europa League, behind closed doors. Seferin then went on though to say we have a number of options right now. Plan A, to restart the season in mid-May. We have Plan B, to restart the season in June. Or we have Plan C, to restart it at the end of June. But he did admit there that if we are not able to do any of those alternatives, the season would probably be lost. And that there is a glaring admission from the UEFA president. If they can't get football going again, if we can't return by the end of June, if we're going into the summer, we may not see the Champions League resume this season. But if we do now move on to the big Barcelona news of the day, and that is basically that the Barcelona players have now accepted to make a wage cut of 70% of their weekly wage during the current crisis, of course, ongoing, and certainly in Spain right now, hitting everybody very, very hard. And certainly this comes after many clubs, many, many players right around the world have all agreed there to take wage cuts. We've spoken on the channel very recently about the amount of money that the Barcelona players earn, and quite clearly, during this situation, it would be difficult to keep their wages coming without any football going on, and they have now accepted that pay cut. Now, I have resisted the urge here to speak about this issue for the past week or so, because over the last week or so, we've heard so many reports basically saying that Barcelona players didn't want to take a wage cut. The likes of Sport, Mundo Deportivo, the sources there quite close to the Barcelona board, basically saying they don't want to take a pay cut. They're not interested in a pay cut. They're all about the money, and they simply will not do it. However, the reason I've resisted the urge there to go down that road is that I'm always sceptical when it comes to those kind of reports when they're coming, you feel, from the side of the board. And that's what we've seen with Lionel Messi this morning openly coming out once again, and for me, taking shots at the board. Because Messi said the following word. He posted this on all of his social media. He said, much has been written and said about the first team football of FC Barcelona in regards to the salaries of the players during this period, a state of alarm. First of all, we want to clarify that our will has always been to apply a drop in salary that we receive, because we fully understand this is an exceptional situation, and we are the first ones who have always helped the club when asked. Even many times when we've also done it on our own initiative, and other times that we thought necessary or important. Therefore, it does not cease to surprise us that from within the club, look at those words there, from within the club, there were those who tried to put us under the magnifying glass and tried to add pressure to do something that we always knew we would do. And that, for me, is very interesting. Messi there again, looking inside of the club, saying there that basically things have come out, things have been released that are simply not true. He said, in fact, if the agreement had been delayed for a few days, it is simply because we were looking to try to find a formula to help the club and also its workers in these difficult times. For our part, the time has come to announce that apart from the reduction of the 70% of our salary during the state of alarm, we will also make contributions so that the club's employees can collect 100% of their salary while this situation lasts. If we did not speak until now, it was because the priority for us was to find solutions that were real to help the club and also to those who were most affected by this situation. He said, "And I don't want to say goodbye without sending an affectionate greeting and a lot of strength to all of the culés who are having a hard time in these very difficult times, as well as all of those who are patiently awaiting the end of this crisis in their homes. Very soon, we are all going to get out of this and we will all do it together. Long live Barca and long live Catalunya." And Lionel Messi there, categorically denying the fact that these Barcelona players didn't want to take that cut. He says if there was a delay, that was only because we didn't just want to take that cut. We also wanted to help there, make sure that all of the club staff, because of course, it's not just about the players, it's not just about the coaching staff. There's so many people involved at Barcelona behind the scenes, at the stadium, at the training ground, of course, inside, outside. There's so many different people involved. And all of those people right now will be struggling to get all of their wages in these sort of times. So the players only there wanted to try and help those out, and Messi, along with several other players as well, on social media, putting out these sort of statements and really dragging the board through the mud once again. Barcelona then, following Messi's statement and many other players as well, they issued a statement of their own. They said the Barcelona board of directors, notice there how the board of directors is first. Is there any need to actually put their names first? They're surely the players in this sort of situation, the cut they've made, the pledge they've made, they should be first on that list. But no, it's the Barcelona board of directors, then the professional sports teams and the basketball team. They have reached an agreement for a reduction in their salaries in the period of state of alarm. In the case of the football first team, the reduction will be over 70% of that originally agreed with the club. The additional contribution by the team, together with the contribution that the club itself shall make, will guarantee 100% of all of the salaries for the non-sporting staff at the club. The club wishes to express its gratitude to all the professional athletes for their commitment during such an exceptional situation that has been caused by this health crisis. So the good news in all this is that the non-playing staff at Barcelona will be guaranteed their wages. The players there have made a very, very good gesture in line with many other of the clubs and players that we've seen in the football world and indeed outside. And I'm really, really glad there that once again, Messi has spoken out and really has shot down those rumours. And it's not just Messi either who's been taking shots at the board over the past few days, because I want to bring you some words now from Xavi Hernandez himself, who sat down over the weekend with La Vanguardia for an interesting interview. It really, really was. He said, "It's clear that I want to return to Barcelona." He said, "I'm very excited about that. Now that I've seen myself coaching, I know that I can bring things to the players, that I can be a coach in my own right." He was then asked, of course, about his decision to reject Barcelona back in January. The job that he's dreamed about, he rejected it there, and does he regret that decision? Xavi said, "I wouldn't take it back. I have no problem with my decision, and I don't hide that." He said, "I would like to work together with people of whom I have confidence in, and whom there is loyalty, and they are very valid people." He said, "They can't be anyone toxic around the dressing room. I made it clear to them that I saw myself in a project that started from nothing, a clean slate, and in which I was able to make the big decisions. And that for me, that is why I'm so, so glad that Xavi, when Bartomeu and co. came knocking in January, he said, you know what? Forget it. Because he is a man there, a principle. He simply doesn't want to work under this board. He wants transparency. He wants honesty. He wants loyalty. And I think certainly he's going to be a key player in Victor Font's campaign. I think he's certainly going to be used in that campaign in 2021. And I think certainly if Victor Font can get in as president of Barcelona, we will be seeing Xavi return to the club in the very near future. And it's just another Barcelona legend that again has spoken out against this board. The final words, though, from Xavi were regard to new additions, new signing to the Barcelona squad. He said, "I don't really think that Barcelona need to make an abundance of signings right now." He said they need some key players. He said, "I don't know if Neymar would fit in terms of the social issues at the club." But he said, in football terms, of course, he would be spectacular. He said they don't need many, many players, but maybe Jadon Sancho or Serge Gnabry could be good options. And I think that's Xavi there, analysing and assessing that within our squad, we do lack there real quality in those wider areas. And Gnabry or Sancho, of course, they'd be brilliant. So that there, guys, brings us to an end in today's news roundup. Some very, very fascinating quotes right across the board. What do you think there of the comments made by Lionel Messi and also there from Xavi Hernandez? And what do you think there about the latest on the European football season? Please leave all your thoughts in the comments down below. Thank you, as always, for joining me. I really, really do appreciate it. I hope you're all doing well. Please stay safe. please stay at home. I will see you shortly. But until next time, as always, Visca! El Barça!